two thin layers separated by a finite distance. Figure 2. This is the principal axis. And the distance between lens L1 and L2 is D. Now the monochromatic light is incident at lens 1 above the H1 distance from the axis. And deviated point B is in H2 height from the axis F1, and the angle of deviation in a first lens is del 1. And the angle of deviation at second lens is del 2. If we replace this lens by a thin lens ED, and then the angle of deviation by thin lens, that is equivalent lens, is del. And F be the focal length of equivalent lens. Now consider a two lens L1 and L2 which are placed in same axis and separated by a finite distance D, and having focal length F1 and F2. Let a monochromatic ray of light, or simply light, is incident at point, this is A and this is B, at point A above the H1 from the axis or principal axis, and deviated by an angle del 1. After refraction, incident ray directed toward the F1. Which is a second principal focus. If two lens L1 and L2 is replaced by a thin lens as shown in figure, which is called equivalent lens. F be the focal length of equivalent lens. Now the deviation produced by a lens L1 is del 1 is equal to H1 upon F1, and similarly the deviation produced by the L2 is del 2 is H2 upon F2, and the deviation produced by equivalent lens, that is del is equal to H1 upon F. Now using a exterior angle theorem, we get del is equal to del 1 plus del 2, or H1 upon F is equal to H1 upon F1 plus H2 upon F2. This is the equation number first. Now, equivalent angle AC1 F1 and BC2 F, we get AC1 upon BC2 is equal to C1 F1 upon C2 F. This implies H1 upon H2 is equal to, this is F1 upon F1 minus D. This is equation number second, or H2 is equal to H1 F1 minus D upon F1 is equation number second B. This is second A. Putting the value of H2 in equation 1, we get H1 upon F is equal to H1 upon F1 plus H1 F1 minus T upon F1 into F2. Or H1 is cancelled out, so we get 1 by F is equal to 1 by F1 plus F1 minus T upon F1 F2. Or 1 by F is equal to F2 plus F1 minus D upon F1 F2. Or F is equal to F1 F2 upon F1 plus F2 minus D. This is the required expression for focal length of equivalent lens. Now D minus F1 plus F2 be the optical separation between two lenses. So F is equal to F1 upon F2 upon del. For a lens to be in contact, that is D is equal to 0, then we get 1 by F is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. Now position of equivalent lens from lens 2 in similar angle. For similar angle EDF and BC2 F1 we get ED upon BC2 is equal to F upon DF C2F, or this is H1 upon BC2 is H2 is equal to DF is F upon this is F minus DC2. Now comparing this equation with this equation, we get F1 minus D is equal to F upon F minus C, or F1 F minus F1 DC2 is equal to F F1 minus FD, or this F1 and F1 is cancelled out, so DC2 is equal to FD upon F1. Since the lens is placed left from the lens 2, so beta is D2 is equal to minus FD upon F1. This is the required expression for the position of equivalent lens from the lens 2. Now the position of equivalent lens from lens 1. For that, this is L1, this is L2. This is F2, this is F, and this intersection point is, here is the equivalence lens ED. Since equivalent lens placed right from the lens 1, so the distance from L1 to equivalent lens is alpha is equal to F D upon F2, similar as above condition. So we get alpha is equal to FD upon F2 and beta is equal to minus FD upon F1 is the position of required positions of lens equivalence lens from lens 1 or lens 2.